Today, we are going to go over the top 5 carnivore mistakes. If you guys would like a shareable PDF of these mistakes, you can go to frank-tefano.com and sign up for the newsletter. Number 1 is start with the baseline. Many jump into the carnivore diet without truly eliminating all allergen concerns, whether it's spicing your food, eating dairy or eggs. It's difficult to gauge your reaction to a food without eliminating it for a period of time, and then reintroducing said food. Generally, beef and wild-caught fin fish is a safe start for most people, although it can be difficult to source quality fat. And this isn't something that needs to be done for forever. You know, you don't have to do this for months at a time. Just for 2-4 weeks, stick to, you know, only low omega-6 meats, beef, wild caught fish, properly pasture raised pork, and wild quality chicken. The problem is most animal foods do contain allergens to what they're being fed, so it can be difficult to figure this out. Some people may be fine with eggs, some people might not be. Some people might be okay with dairy, other people aren't. And you might think you're okay, but until you actually remove that food for a period of time and see how you feel without it, you never really know. Number 2 is fat to protein ratio. Native humans consumed approximately 80% of their calories from energy. That means fat in the context of a carnivore diet. Although most indigenous native groups of humans did have a mix of carbohydrates and fat for 80% of their calories. And this might sound like a lot, but in reality, if you were to eat 1.5 pounds of meat per day and 0.5 pound of fat per day, that's 20% protein to 80% fat, because fat is so much more calorically dense than protein, which has a very high water content. You know, compare a steak to a stick of butter, for instance. And there is a variance depending on the individual's lean body mass. So if you do have more muscle, if you're a bodybuilder, you won't be eating 80% fat. You'll probably be eating closer to, you know, 50 or 60% of your calories from fat. But eating ribeye steaks all day will result in overconsumption of protein to meet fat requirements. And not adhering to this fat to protein ratio is what causes the biggest issues on the carnivore diet long term. You're fatigued, you don't have energy, you're overconsuming food. And this can be difficult for some people because most don't have access to a high quality fat source that is easily digestible, such as, you know, raw grass-fed beef fat or raw grass-fed marrow. Number 3 is omega-3 to omega-6 ratio. This ties in somewhat with our first point of consuming minimally inflammatory foods. When you include eggs, bacon, which are typically from animals fed corn and soy, the omega ratios are thrown off balance. This causes inflammation depending on the degree, but more dangerously stimulates appetite, resulting in excess food consumption. Also, including, you know, farm-raised fish, pork, chicken, most supermarket foods. And beef is on this list. You know, if you're consuming grain-fed beef, the omega-3 to omega-6 ratio is still off enough to cause endocannabinoid satiation issues. Number 4 is that a muscle meat carnivore diet is lacking nutrients. And without eating high quality fat, shellfish, raw dairy, quality pasture raised eggs, it's very difficult to obtain all of the nutrients you need. And eating nose to tail does not accomplish this, contrary to popular belief. You know, human diet is pretty complex in maintaining all the vitamins, all the minerals, omega fatty acids, proper zinc to copper ratio. And these nutrients are also synergistic. So when you're only eating liver and muscle meat and fat, or, you know, you're not in the sun, you're not eating wild fish, your nutrient ratios can be thrown off. Mistake number 5 is variety. And you don't really hear people mention this, but our indigenous ancestors always had 3 types of food preparations present in their diets: raw, cooked, and fermented. Each of these served a purpose. Raw having higher nutrient availability for certain foods, you know, particularly vitamin C, sushi being an approachable option here. Cooked foods yield more calories that are conducive to survival. And also certain cuts of the animal need to be cooked as they are too tough to eat raw. And this also plays a role in colder climates and the thermogenic effects. Number 3, the fermented foods are incredibly important for probiotic bacteria, as well as certain nutrients not found elsewhere. Cheese and charcuterie being 2 common examples. And if you're not feeding your gut bacteria, you need to be consuming that bacteria in some way. And if you're not adhering to all of these principles that I mentioned, you will not be able to follow a carnivore diet long term. And even someone like myself, who has 7 years of experience following this type of diet, has made mistakes due to, you know, our modern world being so different than our past. So thank you guys for joining me today. If you could please like the video, subscribe, Of course, hit that bell icon. And above all, guys, please share the video. If you guys want to support me further, we do have high quality, affordable animal foods available on frankiesfreerangemeat.com. You can also go to Frankie's Naturals for minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products. frank-stefano.com. You guys can check out my book. You can also get the free carnivore diet meal plan when you sign up, in addition to these top five carnivore mistakes. And if you guys would like one-on-one consultations, those are also available on frank-stefano.com. Thanks again for joining me, guys, and enjoy the rest of your day.